got a bunch of goo on my brush. I'm going to show you what to do with that goo. I have a kind of a weird gray here. But it's got all kinds of colors in it. And I take advantage of that by adding white to it. And making kind of cloud forms out of it. These wild cloud forms. And you notice I'm moving my brush all kinds of different ways. Like this. So that it doesn't, the brush is never the same way twice. It's never doing the same exact thing twice. This comes from action painting. I was an action painter in the 1950s. I tried everything. I couldn't keep a job. This I learned from Franz Klein. I used to watch Franz Klein paint in the studio. And he would make the brush move this way and that way in every which direction. And never let it sit still. It would always move. It was always in action. When you saw De Kooning paint, I watched De Kooning paint. He used to paint. Just constant action. Constant moving, moving, and moving. Mother will say that constant action, moving. Pollock I never saw. I saw him paint twice. But any distance, you kept a distance from Paul, you didn't get anywhere close to him. Lee Krasner was a very good friend. She was a very sweet person and a very good painter. She was far better painter than Jackson Pollock, by far better. And she actually gave him the stage and backed off and let him just rule everything. The reason you know his name is because of all the New York school, he was the only one born in the United States. Everyone else was a foreigner. And so... But I learned from Krasner how to keep my brush moving in different directions and rotate it around. She kept saying, rotate your brush, even change hands. Turn your canvas around. Use work upside down. Do anything to break the monotony of this.